Maybe you had some employees that you hired with no experience. Did you do that many interviews with each of them?
Everybody goes through the three interview process as of, you know, I think we might have instituted that. We've been in business for 21 years. That might have been 10 years ago that we've been doing it. It took us a while to figure it out. But the reason we did it is we started keeping track of our hiring mistakes. And what I mean by a hiring mistake is someone that we had to fire, someone that left after being with us for a week, 3 weeks, 3 months, people that we hired that we just, they just couldn't do the job. So anyway, we discovered we weren't getting enough information, useful information about our applicants. And there's, you know, there's no magic to doing that. You basically need enough time and enough good questions to draw out who the person is and isn't. And so, I mean, you could do two interviews, maybe, or four. I don't know. I mean, I don't know if there's three. It just works. The reason why three works so well for us is that it here's what it does for us. The first interview is it's a way to introduce the facility, one or two or three team members to the person, and to assess whether there's enough compatibility and potential to continue investing effort. But one interview isn't enough because we don't have enough people there. We don't have enough eyes on the candidate, and we don't have enough time. So that's why we need the second interview to introduce more people, more eyes, more perspectives on the candidate. And we need that that third interview, what I call the shadow day. That's our opportunity for the entire department to meet that person. So how it would work, again, to use an automotive salesperson as the example, is that that person, we'd invite them on a busy day, like a Saturday afternoon. You know, maybe we'd have them come at 10, leave at 4, or something like that. We'd buy them lunch. They'd join us. And they just hang out. And they listen and they observe. And in between customers, you know, their colleagues will, or their future potential colleagues will come over and, you know, introduce themselves and ask them a few questions. That's an opportunity for the candidate to make sure that this environment is what he or she really wants to be in. So they're not guessing about what it's like to sell cars. They can actually see it happening right before their eyes. And we found that shadow day, perhaps the most important function of it, although there are some other good functions, is that it reduces that quick departure. And what I mean by quick departure is you bring someone on board, you train them, and they quit 2 weeks later. And with the, this isn't what I thought it was. Like, you guys are great, but I just can't do this. And we don't, we invest way too many resources in hiring and training to afford that. And we found that the shadow day, you know, it doesn't eliminate it, but it cuts down on that.
Yeah, it's a great suggestion. You mentioned in your answer and also in the book that you like to get the staff involved in that process of hiring someone. What's that been like for you?
It started, you know, I actually described the incident. I'm so embarrassed, but whatever. It happened, and it was a good mistake because I learned a lot. But I describe in the book an incident where I hired a person, you know, before we had this process developed, you know, after one interview, and we scheduled, and the guy just never even showed up. Like, he quit as he told me he was giving us 2 weeks' notice, and he just, like, the day that he was supposed to arrive came, and he didn't even show up. He didn't call me, didn't email me, just vaporized. And I realized that I wasn't, you know, I have pretty good intuition about people, but, you know, I have my own blind spots and limitations and perspectives and biases, and you can mitigate those limitations by expanding the number of eyes that are looking at a candidate. And sometimes we'll have a single person, you know, in a department, you know, the candidate will meet 10 people and that one person will say, you know what, he mentioned something to me about this experience that happened to him at a former employer, and I didn't really like the way he talked about it, you know, which then gives us an opportunity to dig in a little deeper. We'll have a fourth interview. We've done that. You know, if we're like on the fence about someone, we'll come back in and we'll address those questions that we have or any concerns that maybe people raised. It's not part of our process normally, but we will do it, you know, as necessary. And I think that the more eyes you get, the more red flags you see. But more importantly, too, it's a gift to your teams that, and it says a lot, doesn't it, when you have an opportunity as a line person in your company to have an impact or an influence. You get to influence who your colleagues are going to be. Like, people don't just show up, oh, here's your new colleague. Like, you already met that person and had a chance to interact with them and had a chance to give your feedback on that candidate. And I think that's, you know, one of the million bricks in building a healthy company culture.
Mm. And especially if you combine it with your shadow day that you said, I guess it's possible that someone might interact with someone else differently than they might interact with you, maybe.
Oh, certainly. Yeah. I mean, I think that, you know, the psychologists talk about personalities being transactional, and it's a very technical word in the context that means we are different people to different people. And I think we can all relate to that, right? I mean, I think when we get around our buddies, maybe we're a little sillier, a little crazier than we are with, you know, important business contacts where we might be more formal. And they know us in a different way than our buddies do. Mm-hmm. So I think that by interacting with different people, different aspects of the candidate's personality,